recital. We're going to start with a piece I've dreamed about performing for about 12 years, which is how long it took for me to become good enough to play it, or at least to develop an ego big enough to think I can play it. We'll find out which one very shortly. Camille Saint-Saëns' introduction and Rondo Capriccioso was composed for violin and orchestra in 1863. It was dedicated to and premiered by Pablo de Sarasate on the violin, and Saint-Saëns himself conducted the orchestra. Tonight, I will be the violin, and the fabulous Brendan Hollins will be the orchestra. We hope you enjoy the Kyriakov arrangement of Camille Saint-Saëns' introduction and Rondo Capriccioso.
Thank you.
Spanish songs by composer Manuel de Falla. The songs are from different parts of Spain, but they are all about love and courtship, from young love to heartbreak, from babies fussing in the back of others to the jealous rage of a scorned lover. I'm sorry, Olivia. It's her first recital. We figured it may as well be in one of her parents. Anyway, one of the reasons I really love this collection of songs is because of the diversity of Spanish style and emotion. We hope you enjoy these 7 songs as much as we do.
Thank you.
Recital will be better. Well, we've performed violin and vocal music. I think it's about time we perform something for the flugelhorn. And trumpet. This lovely piece composed by Richard Peasley is called Night Songs, and it features the trumpet, flugelhorn, and piano in music that evokes the beauty of a peaceful moonlit night, as well as more than one mysterious ruckus, probably raccoons in the trash can again. Without further ado, Richard Peasley's Night Songs.
Thank you.
popular piece written for the E-flat trumpet, arguably the most played and most well-known piece in all of trumpet repertoire, is a concerto composed by Franz Joseph Haydn. And the second most popular E-flat trumpet work is a concerto composed by Johann Hummel. And that's about it for works written for E-flat trumpet. But dang, we gotta justify buying this thing to our spouses somehow. And saying,
well, there are these two really, really important concertos.
Sounds like a pretty weak argument for a multi-$1,000 purchase. To a non-trumpet player, at least. So to conclude our program, Brendan and I are going to augment that list a little and perform a concerto for horn in E-flat by Czech composer Johann Neruda that has become a staple in the repertoire of married E-flat trumpet owners everywhere. We hope you enjoy. Thank you so much for attending our seminar. Sorry for the Haydn surprise.
I was wondering if I should bring the Haydn and put it on the score.
Thank you.